all smiles. The song that came through was Ain't No Sunshine When She's Gone. But then there was two more songs. It's My Life, I think, by Bon Jovi. And this one was very bizarre, but somebody will get it. Who's Gonna Fill Their Shoes by George Jones. Somebody is going way, way back with that one. That reminds me of my childhood. All right, Spirit, this is going to be the daily message, if I may, please. Can I have a prayer for the daily message for this collective? Dear God, thank you for your gift of life, of faith, and of my calling. Thank you for the opportunity to serve you and others. Dear Father, thank you for making me your beloved child now and forever. Amen. So you either have a calling on your life and you're already stepped into that, or that's what's being encouraged, is what I'm going to say. Let's see what virtues are working right now. What virtues are you working on in this collective, Spirit? We've been seeing, this week has gone by very fast. Compassion, which makes perfect sense with the prayer. Patience. And courage. Patience, compassion, and courage. I don't feel like I've gotten much accomplished this week. That's just how fast this week has flown by for me. Oh, well. You do what you can, as Miss Mary says. What healing are we working on today, Spirit, in person A over here? Somebody's selling out. All right, what about person B? Victim consciousness. Ooh, and sadness. I'd be sad, too, if I was selling out and playing the damn victim. Selling out. This is the prostitute archetype, and we're losing power in places where we're selling out. Over here, we're playing the victim, or we are actually a victim, and we're standing up for ourselves. Maybe you work with victims. Somebody's a victim. Or feels like one. My palm is itching this morning. Alright, let's get one of these. These are always very nice. Speak to us, Spirit, for person A over here. What does person A need to know? Breathe and go to the studio. Get in flow. Breathe and get in flow. If you're over here selling out, person A, go buy the book and breathe. So maybe you're cutting corners and that's why you're selling out. I feel you. The fate and selling out. No, breathe. The fate and breathe, rather. All right. May I have an oracle message for person A over here, Spirit? Like, this picture somebody has a very loyal heart here and now, or they don't. There's a sense of loyalty. Or of not being loyal. Alright, how about person B? Higher power tried to flip over for them. Everything's coming out in reverse. Person B, you have Treasure Island and New Life, but it's in reverse. And then we have flexible. We have to be more flexible. We're too rigid. Alright, so person A that's selling out over here. You have a loyal heart. I think your loyalty is what's tripping you up. I think you're being loyal to the wrong things. That's what I think. But let's see what Spirit says. Number 35 and number 32. Here and now, number 32 is about being fully present in the moment, living one day at a time. But it's in reverse, so you get the protective message. And thus says this. Whenever you find your mind drifting into the past or wondering if things could have or should have been better, or whenever you find yourself longing for the good old days, you're leaking power. The same is true of looking too far ahead and hoping the future will provide you with certainty. Driven by ambition, you might wander too long in this place with no substance and forget that you are here today. The past and future are illusions. You remember the songs that came through, the Bon Jovi and the George Jones? Somebody's trying to stay too far in the past. And it has something to do with no sunshine when she's gone. Or he's gone, whichever the case may be. Whenever you leave the present moment, you're disconnecting from your inherent power to manifest your reality with true substance. Neither past nor future can give you what you need. Now is all that counts. So come back from those eternities and be here now. All will be well, and miracles will appear as if by magic in the perfect timing of Spirit. And then number 35, loyal heart. And you get the protective message with that as well, because it's in reverse. And the meaning of loyal heart is loyalty, devotion, fidelity. This is the protection message. Are you stubborn or overly tenacious about an idea? Or have you become so attached to something that you just don't know how to let it go? And here we are back to letting it go. Remember yesterday, letting it go and saying what you mean? Could it be that it's become so much a part of you that you wouldn't know who you are without it? Now is the time to look at outdated beliefs, old ideas, and misplaced loyalties. Betrayal is only a signal that it is time to prune away all who don't serve you, your trust. Now is the time to look at outdated beliefs, old ideas, and misplaced loyalties. Betrayal is only a signal that it is time to prune away all who don't serve your trust. Dude, why do I keep saying serve your trust when it very plainly says deserve your trust? Because somebody is trying to get you to be loyal to their bullshit. That's why. Betrayal, they're betraying you. And it's only a signal that it is time to prune away all who don't deserve your trust and have no place in your life. Be new, think new, and open your heart to new things. Let go of the old and all your attachments. Spirit has awesome plans for you. Make some room. So, there's something or someone in your life that you are selling out. You're selling yourself short because you have decided that you just simply cannot live without this thing or person. That you cannot give this up because doing so would be some sort of being disloyal. And they don't deserve your trust. Because if they truly cared about you, they would not be asking you to sell out, would they? And then we have victim. Somebody plays the victim. We've been seeing that for weeks now. Number 9, Treasure Island. And number 39, New Life. Number 9, Treasure Island, and you get the protective message also. poverty consciousness and a sense of not enough cast a shadow on your path. These ideas and core beliefs come with a high cost. Do you really want to proclaim yourself a victim of disappointment and failed expectations? Are you avoiding success because you will grow so tall that others will want to cut you down? Or is it possible that you're caught in a fear that you will lose what you have acquired, so you hold on so tight that you miss the opportunities to expand? You are challenged to change the way you see the world and move from a perception of limitations to a perception of abundance. Take a risk, for you have nothing to lose except your confinement in a prison of your own making. Open the door and find the abundance waiting for you to claim it. So you have put yourself in a prison of your own making by this victim. Playing this victim. And Spirit wants you to have new life. 39. You must acknowledge your inexperience and gently allow yourself to be like the delicate new bud opening. It's okay to admit that you may not know something. You are at the beginning of things and haven't yet hit your stride. Be immersed in the newness of it all, and don't try to rush the learning process. New life has its own timetable for maturity. Be here now. Life loves you. And I think that it's safe to say that you are all one person. B and A, this might be just two sides of yourself. And in order to accomplish these things, you have to be flexible. But you're trying to be loyal to the wrong things. You're trying to be loyal to things that don't deserve your trust. And you're either going too far to the past or into the future. It's like you're not satisfied with what's happening in today. And I think it's because you realize that you're selling out and you're very unhappy doing that. I think you know this is not what you want for yourself. And instead of facing it head on, you're trying to escape by reminiscing and thinking back to the good old days. And well, what's wrong with today? Maybe it's time to be loyal to yourself today. And then over here we have this person that likes to play the victim. And nobody wins when you play the victim. This is a very codependent feel. Somebody here has a big dose of codependent bullshit going on with them. Big time, big time. What spiritual gifts are they operating with, Spirit? What psychic abilities are operating in this situation? Rainbow. The rainbow. Alright, what about over here where they're playing the victim? Spirit's perspective. So, there's this sense that there's not a lot of psychic ability going on here at all. It's all about Spirit and promising you a better today. And you being able to see things from a larger perspective. Because right now, you're zeroed in on your own self and how you've been a victim. You may feel like a victim of society and the rules of society. And this is your excuse for why you sell out. If I just had more opportunity, if I hadn't have had such a tough upcoming in my childhood, then I wouldn't be a victim of my circumstances today. Maybe. But you still don't have to be a victim of your circumstances today. You can choose to see things from a larger perspective. You can choose new life. But you're moving away from this new life further and further every day. And I feel that. I feel that you're almost disconnected from even the videos. That you're just like, they, you know, at first I thought you might be onto something here. But now I'm not so sure. Now I'm not so sure that you even know how to help me. No, I don't. You have to help yourself. You have to be responsible for your own healing, baby. You're responsible for that. And I see that you're moving further and further away from it to the point of, I'm going to just stop watching. But Spirit is giving you an opportunity to look at this one more time and decide. Because this is what I see here. I see somebody who wants to sell out and wants to play the victim. And I might piss you off, okay? But that's all right. You'll get over it. But you're looking for an excuse for why it's okay that you've done this instead of how can I stop doing this? That's what I see. I see somebody who wants somebody to give them an excuse to keep doing the same thing and getting the same result, hoping that somehow it'll change without you having to do a damn thing about it. And that's just not how it works. That's just not how it works. All right, Spirit, what would you say to us out of the Power Thought cards? To this person that I see selling out, that's playing the victim. Freedom is my divine right. You have a right to freedom. You have to unlock the door and walk out of the prison. You are still very much locked in a prison because of your own thoughts. I open new doors to life. Spirit wants you to open new doors to life and know that freedom is your divine right. And that you're worth loving. Somehow you don't feel like you're worth loving. And I trust the process of life. We have to trust the process. And it is a process. And you either want to be so far in the past that you're not responsible, or so far in the future that you're fantasizing. Spirit, how can I help this person? Or can I even help this person? Okay. May I get messages for this person that I see over here who's selling out? All right. There's jealousy. There's jealousy here. And you're having differences with somebody about online dating. And this is, okay, this something that my husband and I used to have differences about when it came to online, is that he used to get very angry with me, that I would lay in the bed with him at night and play on my phone and ignore him laying right beside me. And he was right, I did do that. And then he finally got a smartphone and he started to do it also. Speaking of the devil. And so then it was okay. We didn't have those fights anymore. But there was a time when he was very jealous of my smartphone. Or it could literally be that you're having differences because of online dating. And somebody's jealous because you're dating somebody online. But that's what selling out is about. All right, talk to me about this victim over here. Oh, my God. This person is undecided about self-pleasure and something being incomparable. I don't even know if I even want to go anywhere with that. It's about you being worth loving. And somebody, I choose you. So this person is over here and they're jealous because you're on your phone talking to other people all the time. And you're over here like, I have to please myself. And I'm undecided about my own self. The incomparable here is about you feeling like you're competing with this online stuff. Maybe they have a sex addiction and they're into pornography, and that's how they're selling out. And you're over here undecided. This could be the same person that's selling out to this online stuff, and you're having differences in your own mind. You may be jealous of what you're seeing online. And you're undecided if this is bringing you any pleasure. In this case, self-pleasure could just mean, you know, I'm undecided if what I'm seeing online is even bringing me pleasure. Like I was saying a while ago, like, when you first started watching the videos, I could feel that your energy was pumped and revved, and you just knew that this was going to be what could help you to get past this. But now you're not so sure anymore. Anything else we need to know here, Spirit? Spirit says there's about to be a reconciliation and somebody is on the verge. Don't force it. Somebody's on the verge. Don't force it. And so I won't. I will leave you alone, alone, alone with your solitude. Let's see. May I please see the energy of this person's spirit? Show me what's going on. Show me how they think. How do they think? How do they think? May I see how they feel? On the verge of the lion and the unicorn. So you're a deeply spiritual person. reverse, withdrawn, and you're too serious. You're withdrawn and you're too serious. And then the unicorn. Is one of the most spiritual cards there is. Unicorn. Reconnecting to higher wisdom or divinity. It's difficult to see, hear, or think of a unicorn without immediately questioning if it's real. Did they ever exist? Perhaps long, long ago. The mind answers maybe, or it could be, or no way. This very contemplation explains our relationship with divinity and encapsulates our wavering belief in the unicorn. We wonder what divinity is. We wonder where our intuition comes from and if we can really trust it. We think about a higher power and our mind hesitates between yes, no, and maybe. Is it male or female? Does it have a name? Or is it just a feeling? The unicorn card appears and wakes us up to curiosity about the higher self and the divine. It is a card of questioning, exploring, and contemplating the inexplicable. The mind's eye knows there is something beyond our day-to-day lives, a deeper dimension to our experiences. The mind's eye reaches and reaches and reaches out to grasp. So, something more. You are the unicorn, and you have begun your quest for answers. So you are on a quest for answers. But I'm not so sure you really want these answers. Because of the selling out and the victim consciousness. But Spirit is insisting that I not force it, that you're on the verge here. The eyes are going to listen. What should I do, Spirit? Why am I here then? All right. How are you working in the collective with our... The Emperor, the Sun, the Wheel, and the Tower in reverse. The Emperor, the Sun, the Wheel, and a Tower in reverse. And the Fool, and the Lovers. We've got a lot of shit going on. You got a lot going on, no doubt about it. This is a boss. I'm the boss of me. This is the part of you that gets things done, that's hardworking and driven and motivated, but can also be very crusty and hard and bitter. So this is about this Emperor energy being happy and having something fortunate happen when what they're expecting is a tower. You're expecting, it's like this sense of everything's gonna fall to shit. It's just a matter of when. You're waiting for the other shoe to drop. It's like nothing good has ever happened for me. This woe is me type victimhood. And because nothing has ever happened good for me, I'm sure that nothing else is going to happen good for me. You're going through a moment of, you're fighting it. You're hoping that you can have happiness and fortune. But you're sure that it's not available for you. What could have possibly happened to this person's spirit to make them so jaded? Fulfilling a fantasy, expired, disguised, old news, discarded, and outdated. So you have some outdated beliefs about yourself and you're fantasizing. Maybe even fantasizing about the past. What? Show me what happened here. Caution. What do you mean, caution? Why is caution here? Because somebody is a great actor putting on a show, when all they really know how to do is run away. And they're in their feelings. Somebody is pretending like they're going to run away and they're in their feelings. And you're looking for proof of the divine keeping a promise. You're pretending you're an actor putting on a show, and you're running from your feelings. What are you saying? What are they feeling? Oh, okay. Spirit says you might be money hungry. That's how you're selling out. You want more money, and you will do anything to have more money. A love story once upon a time. So you had somebody you loved once upon a time, but you were money hungry. What happened to this person they loved? Somehow you're keeping a promise. The person you loved is keeping a promise. Clarify what that means. Somebody's been getting played, manipulation, lies, controlling, and pulling the strings. And it's a diamond girl. Somebody who was born to shine. So you're money hungry and keeping a promise and getting played by this woman. Or that's maybe how you feel. Yeah, this is how you feel. You feel like somebody is pretending and that they're going to run away. And that this is total drama. What's the truth? Because this sounds like bullshit to me. Wow. You've been having tantric sex? Astral projection sex? Fulfilling a fantasy? And you're spoiled. Somebody spoils you but you're insecure and busy. So you have literally been having astral projection sex and fulfilling a fantasy this way. Getting spoiled. And this is why you're insecure. Wow. I don't even know what to say. Like, this is toxic shit. This is like toxic and over the top toxic shit. This is why somebody's jealous and has differences with you, because of this tantric sex that you've been engaging in to fulfill your fantasies. This is why people have to protect themselves from you, because you are using people for sex, and they're not even aware of it. Wow. Total drama. If you don't understand what I'm saying, then you probably don't need to. This is really blowing my fucking mind. Women, protect your energy. This is a predator like you would not believe. This person is having fantasy sex. Self-pleasure with women who are not protecting their energy. And it looks like they have somebody that they live with that cares about them, and they're jealous. What kind of sicko does this kind of shit? I don't know if I even care to know anything else about this. What would you say to this person? What the fuck is up with you? I often wonder how you feel about me. What would they say to you? They reread all of your text messages. They want to have a booty call. And they know your fine ass is not single. I hate you. Fuck you, fuck you, fuck you. I guess you do. This person is sick. They're taking advantage of people who don't know enough about it to protect themselves. Why is the Emperor here? Remember, I said the Sun, because of a relationship that they're thinking about moving forward with, that they think would make them happy, but they're soul-searching about it. Why is the sun here twice? Because of a lie. Clarify the lie. You're already in a relationship. And the lie is that your person refuses offers from you. That's a lie. What's the truth? Your person is tired of your tantric bullshit. There's a lot of memories of pain between you and your person. That's the truth. Why is the wheel here? Because of having it all. What do you mean having it all? Justice. Look. Do you see what they're doing? Laying in the bed beside each other on the phone with other people. You're not going to have it all. You're fixing to lose it all to a divorce. Why is the tower in reverse? Because you looked for a perfect opportunity to move, and now you want to move back. Where do they want to move back to? Cancer is here in Gemini, Libra, Clair. You want to move back to somebody that you have a lot of feelings for, but also it looks like to me you want to move back to somebody who's shallow and manipulative. What do you mean by shallow and manipulative? Somebody that you've fought a lot with, and what did they not recognize here? They didn't recognize this Ace of Wands. What about the Ace of Wands? This is this tantric sex. They didn't realize you were involved in this. You kept this a secret. I don't even know what to say about this. This is disturbing. Why is the Emperor here? What a catch. Because of a real teeny tiny offer that was withdrawn from somebody that was a catch. Why is the Sun here? Because of you breaking up with somebody that things worked with. Why is the wheel here? Because of you being defensive, putting up walls when it comes to children. Defending yourself when it comes to children and unconditional love because you feel like you cannot be trusted. Why is the wheel here? Because of you bickering and fighting with an empress. Because somebody won't see their part in this. And why is the tower here? Because of somebody being divinely guided to hear the truth. What do you mean truth? There's the emperor. This is probably some of the most disturbing thing. This is the most disturbing thing I've ever read about. I don't even know what to say. Like, I am... There's envy. You know, already knowing the tea and coming in after you. Somebody's coming in after who? This once upon a time love story. Somebody needs anger management and the police were involved. You all got in a fight. Somebody came after you. And made some bad choices. What's going to be the outcome for this person now, Spirit? You like to go to the gym and work out. You don't want to hear it. You're all torn up and falling apart. Somebody's a copycat. They've been destroyed, shattered, broken, and fucked up. And fighting for what you love, claiming what's yours. Love is a battlefield. And card and rock deck alert. Divine timing. You know what? You were right. Private relationship. You were right when you said that I couldn't help you. I can't. That's why you've been burning the evidence. You're right. I can't help you. This is beyond my pay grade. Angels, how are you helping? Showing grace and putting things where they need to be for somebody's highest and greatest good. And there's a divine plan. Adoration. I'm getting sick to my stomach again. What would you say to this person, Spirit? There's an Empress that's got a lot of love, strength, empowerment, spirit guide, and your dreams, and your animals, life purpose, and having confidence in not having a commitment. Somebody here takes fantasizing and having sex to a whole new level, like in this virtual reality. But it's not really virtual, it's real people and it's their souls that this person is after. This person looks for women who have vulnerability so that they can have sex with them in the astral realms. and they're married, and the person they're married to knows that they do this, and they're jealous. Until you're ready, nobody can help you. That's all I have to say to you. And I'm protected from you. But I would appreciate if you would not come back until you're ready for help. In fact, I'm insisting on it.